Okay, guys, for today, I will introduce the all-in-one oscillator that includes multi-time frame component and regular and hidden divergence as well. I will try to do it in less than 5 minutes. That's my personal challenge for today. Cool. So, in this indicator, there are like 11 different oscillators. So, once again, it's not a trading method. It's an utility script that you can use for your own trading. Like, for instance, like you can use it with your own indicator, with your own algorithm builder, for instance, and whenever there is a convergence between that one and your own system, that's a good way to profit from trading, to look for convergence and to look for trend. You can choose MACD, the RSI, the average full range, the stochastic, Chandler momentum oscillator, etc., etc. So let's try with a MACD. So when you select a MACD, hop, I will like you will have to adjust the scaling, and let's say like I want to capture the regular divergence for my MACD. See, so like you're going to have those labels here. R is like is RB is like a regular divergence, and when you want to capture the hidden, you're going to have the H here. And if you want to do that in a different time frame, you can select, for instance, in daily. And yeah, so basically, you don't see the divergence because comparing the daily MACD divergence with a 4 hours Bitcoin chart doesn't make sense. So that's why. That's why you don't see the divergence. I usually check the divergence when it's the same short time frame. So let's use the relative strength index. Let's adjust the scaling. So I have this question for every day, at least twice, to adjust your scaling, like whenever it looks like that, right-click and select this one, auto fits data to screen. And boom, it's working very well. So yeah, and what else? What else? So you have the relative strength index, you have the multi-time frame, you have the divergence regular and hidden. We cover that. We cover different time frame, and of course, the alerts. So the alerts plus select. The best, and you have basically the alert for buy and sell, right? So for the alerts, sometimes like you want to play, sometimes like you want to play the safe mode, like, or sometimes you want to play the reverse. For instance, that's why we have this option, basically safe cross mode. So I will remove the divergence. And if I use a safe cross mode on my relative strength index, and if I set up a buy, if I set up a buy, where I'm going to have the buy alert, it's here. If I uncheck safe cross mode, where I'm going to have the buy, it's here. Why safe? Because it's safer to wait, in my opinion, for the oscillator to come back between the oversold and overbought zone, rather than waiting for this cross here. But depends of your strategy, depends of your trading, depends of your capital, depends of your psychology, depends of your mood, depends on basically you. Right, and that's all for today. And I made it in less than 5 minutes, so I'm quite happy about it.